Hey everyone, welcome back to the lab. In this video, we're going to be talking about F-sharp early returns, and specifically how to write early returns with simple if-else statements without the monads. So F-sharp is a beautiful language, but a lot of its code looks a little weird. It achieves its beauty by being very particular about the paradigms it supports, often discarding patterns used by mainstream languages that have revealed themselves to be negatives rather than positives over the years. And now, this can make picking up F-sharp kinda hard. Things look a little weird, common patterns that you might use in like a mainstream OO, not really good types language don't really translate as well over to this new paradigm. And so this kind of leads you to coding a little bit slower. And so one of the biggest struggles I had when I got into F-sharp and I started building my own like first projects was how do I write early returns? Now, early returns are a very common way to make your code cleaner in mainstream languages by hoisting invalid conditions to the top of a function, which allows you to reduce the nesting complexity in the body. I think a lot of programmers, when they first start out, they love to do like these super nested conditionals. And so you end up with like four levels of nesting. Nobody can read that stuff. Don't do it. So early returns are very helpful in that regard. And this works in like most languages, but F-sharp is a bit more functional than that and tends to bias towards more expressive techniques like monads to achieve this. And I think this makes sense when you understand monads, but monads are very confusing. And I'll be honest, I don't even have my head fully wrapped around them. They're still confusing to me. And so I think early returns are a very reasonable pattern in the rest of programming. And so I think they're very reasonable even in F-sharp because they're very readable, very easy to understand. And honestly, it's not that bad. So in this post, I'm gonna show you just how to quickly, easily do this so you don't get stuck like I did. All right, F-sharp early returns. So we can achieve early returns in F-sharp by relying on the if-then-else conditionals. And this is basically just like an if-else in other languages, but it's a little bit more powerful, works a little bit differently. And so that's how we use it for early returns. And so as usual, you know, you got if a condition, then it's a little bit different where we say then, and this is what we do if it's true. And then we have else, which continues on. Now remember that in F-sharp, the reason it's a little weird and why these like early returns don't work as well is because every path returns something. And so this is excellent for composability. This is excellent for railroading and monads and like all these like higher order things. But that's just not a mainstream thing. And so this is what we're trying to get around and why we have to use this little pattern. You don't have to fully understand this. Hopefully the pattern will be easy enough to implement yourself. And so by filling out the then with the early return value you'd like, you can achieve early returns without monads, because we're basically saying this is a new path that's going to return something. Here's the return value. Go use it. And so to make this more concrete, here is some code. I have it here on my website. I also have this in a replet, and where's the replet? Right here. So I'll open that up so you can get some syntax highlighting. Okay, and so here's early return right here. And basically this is a function, this is a parameter, this is a result, and then we're saying here's the function body. And what we're doing is, hey, if condition, then we wanna go in here. And so here you can put in some logic if you want. Here I'm just printing something out. Obviously you wanna stay away from side effects, but you know, you can do extra logic here, and then we're returning true. And so this satisfies the idea that every branch needs to have a return. And so that's why this works as an early return. And then what you can do is say, hey, if we don't have that, then we're gonna continue on. And so you can do whatever you want here. And this is how you can achieve your early returns with a simple if then else. Now note that you can chain multiple of these together. And so this might look pretty simple because it is a simple function, but we can actually chain it more together. And this is probably more when you're reaching for early returns. So we're gonna have a lot of conditionals, a lot of things you wanna check an early return on if they're invalid. And so here we have our function. We have two bools that say, do we wanna return early in the first one or the second one? And then it's just gonna return a tuple of what we input or what the branch is. And so here we have that same if then else, if you were to set should early one return. But then we can do the same thing again. And so this is how we can get our multi-conditions, which is very common with early returns in most languages. And then again, you can keep, you know, doing whatever your logic is and then do the function body. Yep. And I have a link to the replit here if you want to use this, play around with it, see if it works as you expect. So yeah, that's early returns in F sharp. So F sharp is my favorite language, but there is a bit of a learning curve to relearn some patterns of doing things. In my opinion, a lot of the mainstream languages are not using best practices. In fact, they're using practices we've known are bad for several decades. F sharp is trying to kind of get rid of some of those bad practices and use better practices, but you know, the status quo is bad. So it's gonna be a little bit hard to like get onto a less bad pattern. Long term, I do think simple monads lend better to composability and railroad systems and these kind of like really cool, safer, more flexible, more composable, like just better systems overall. But it does take some learning. And so I think if then else is like a totally viable option, both in the early stages of learning these techniques and also even in the later stages, sometimes it's just easier to write this stuff. And it's not bad. It's just, you know, not necessarily the best paradigm overall, but I still think it's pretty good. And I still use them in my own projects a lot when it's just simpler to do. So that's it for this post. If you liked this post, you might also like formatting F sharp functions the right way. The F sharp I showed you, I'm very particular about how I format things. It talks more about that and why I decided to go this way. You can also check out the best way to get started learning and building with F sharp, which is a compilation of all the best materials I found for different aspects that you would need to learn to actually start building with F sharp. And then also how I got interested in F sharp, which is kind of how I landed on F sharp being my favorite language, why I've been using it for the past several years to build all my projects, stuff like that. So that's it for this video. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.